Hi friends, welcome to Easy Learn. This is the first part of NEET MTS solved MCQs with explanation. I have included memory tips also. First question, rubber dam was introduced by A. Tommy Hanks, B. S.C. Barnum, C. Headstrom, D. G.V. Black. Answer is B. S.C. Barnum. It's just a theory question, but when it comes for exam, are we able to recollect this? I am writing here rubber and Barnum. So, rubber and bar relate like that. So, rubber dam, Barnum. Study like that. Next question. Surgical removal of torus is indicated when A. Torus impinges on soft palate, B. It interferes with development of proper PPS. C. Torus is an undercut that traps debris and food. D. All of the above. Answer is D. All of the above. Coming into torus palatinus, that is maxillary tori, it's a common exostosis that occurs in midline of vault of hard palate. It comes in different shapes like single, that is dome shape, spindle, nodula, lobula or multiple. It's composed of cortical bone and may have cancellous component. Mandibular tori is found on the lingual surface of the mandible opposite the canine and premolar region. Usually it is bilateral, may be single, multiple or lobulated. Indications for removal of maxillary tori includes when it interferes with speech, when there is loss of posterior palatal cell, and when there is poor denture stability. Usually, all mandibular tori should be excised because the mucosa over the tori is more prone to irritation due to constant movement of the denture during mastication. Next question. Passive impression technique involves A. Impression with silicone, B. With impression compound, C. Impression plaster, D. Alginate. Answer is C. Impression plaster. Here, in this technique, impression is made with the oral mucous membrane and the jaws in a very normal, relaxed condition. Border molding is not done here. The impression is made with an oversized tray. The material of choice is impression plaster. It is also known as minimal pressure technique. Next question. Which of the following is not the principal fiber group of periodontal ligament? A. Horizontal, B. Oblique, C. Alveolar crest, D. Transeptal. Answer is D. Transeptal. Transeptal fibers are considered as gingival fibers because they do not have osseous attachment. In this picture, red line denotes transeptal fibers. Transeptal fibers are located interproximally, form horizontal bundles and extend between the cementum of the approximating teeth into which they are embedded. So, transeptal fibers comes under gingival fibers. Gingival fibers are arranged in three groups. They are gingivodental, circular and transeptal. Once more, gingival fibers are grouped into gingivodental fibers, circular fibers and transeptal fibers. The gingivodental fibers are embedded in the cementum just beneath the epithelium at the base of the gingival sulcus. The circular fibers course through the connective tissue of the marginal and interdental gingiva and encircle the tooth in ring-like fashion. Next question. Best for maxillary sinus. A. Reverse Towns view, B. Submentovertex view, C. Waters view, D. PA view. Answer is C. Waters view. Waters view is also known as occipitomental view or nose chin position. Here, nose and chin touch the film and X-ray beam is projected from occipital side. It shows facial skeleton and maxillary antra and avoids superimposition of the dense bone of the skull. Indications are investigation of maxillary antra, detection of middle third fractures, coronoid process fractures, frontal and ethmoidal sinus, orbital blowout. So, how to memorize Water's view is for maxillary sinus? Just flip it out the letter W. It will become M. So, for maxillary sinus, Water's view. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.